Good day, everyone. As you can see, I'm sweating. I have taken bath like 3 times in 24 hours. That's a first. Actually, I kind of compensated for the 3 days which I didn't even take a shower inside the Trans-Siberian Railways. I returned just yesterday, and today I have 0 things to eat, 0 things to cook in my room. So I'm going grocery shopping, and as I promised, I'm taking you all along with me to show you around the grocery store. But first, let's go and have some lunch. So today for grocery shopping, we have come to one of the biggest malls and biggest supermarkets in Vladivostok. It is actually one of the newest places to be opened in here. It opened about 1 or 2 years before. So it's actually kind of new, and it's the last mall which actually opened in here. After this, nothing new has come up. This shop is actually pretty big, and most of the students from our college shop either in the shop in here or the same brand of stores that are in the city. The other store is actually much closer to the bus station. Coming here, you have to at least take 2 buses or take 1 bus and then walk a lot. Actually, people who come here actually shop in groups, because they go back by taxi and they can share the taxi fare. So being inside the mall is actually kind of pleasant because there is air conditioning in here. Actually, this year the summer is comparatively pretty hot than the summer last year when I was in Vladivostok. Comparatively to Moscow, it is kind of cooler, but the humidity is really high that I sweat a lot. It becomes really difficult if you don't have air conditioning or a ventilation system like a fan. So the shop we are going to is called a Samberi, the one which is besides me. It has about 2 to 3 branches inside Vladivostok. It might be more in the neighboring regions, but I haven't been there. So it is one of the biggest shops that have been established in the recent years, like 3 to 4 years back. 3 years back, there was another shop which I used to go to, but then this became the only option after the other shop closed. So this is the biggest in here now, and most people from our university shop here. So within the 14 days I have not been in here, the sections have changed. Like, the vegetable section used to be on the other side and the fruit section used to be in this side, but they have changed it ulta. And so let me show you around. That's 1 coconut. So most supermarkets in Russia, you would find 2 sections or departments to be really big. One is the meat section, which has sausages, normal beef, chicken, fish, etc. And the next one is bread. They have a really huge bakery section in each and every supermarket, be it small or big. The bakery section is the biggest one, because it would be the biggest department as close to meat and dairy. So next I'll show you the meat section. Supermarkets, the meat section, especially the chicken section, you get it in different parts of the chicken, like the breast is sold separately, the thighs are sold separately, the legs are sold separately. Breasts which are boneless and skinless cost the highest, while the wings and the legs cost the least. Also, there is an option of buying the chicken frozen if you are going to keep it for longer, and if your freezer is in a really good condition, that's also a nice option to try. We have come to the breakfast cereal section, and this side is the BS Lactosni, that is the lactose free milk, because I'm lactose intolerant. But the cereal aisle is actually pretty, restricted. Not as much that we find in India, because I don't know if children eat cereal in here. There are really less amount of cereal, and most of it is just sweetened cornflakes. So we have come into the bakery section of the grocery aisle, that is towards flour. We have usually the mixed type flour which has wheat and maida in it, and mostly it is just baking flour, so it has mostly maida in it, and that is the cheapest one. You can also get a type of flour which is only wheat. There are also other types like rice flour and stuff available in here, which I only recently discovered after living 5 years in here. So we are here in the masala section of the store, and this is the main section for us Indians, because we use a lot of it in our cooking. So I'll basically say what are all are available in here. You can get red chili powder, which is actually a bit costly, but it also comes in really small quantities. Most of the masalas in here come in really small quantities. So you get red chili powder in here, you get your normal pepper. You can also get cumin powder and coriander powder. Cumin powder is rare, but coriander powder is there. Cumin you can actually get in the full form. You also get most of the garam masalas in their fullest forms, like the bay leaves and cloves, etc. You get those in here. You can maybe grind them in the correct mixture to make garam masalas. Except for the specialized masalas, we get most of the things in here, like the chili powders and stuff. Also, there is something called as curry powder. Wait, let me show you. Yeah, this is the curry pripravka, which I use in cooking for making chicken curries, etc. This is an alternative if you are into the Russian version of the chicken curry that we make in India. So this can be helpful. I only cook with this because I ran out of most of my masalas I got from India, because I haven't been there in over 2 years, 2-3 years. Also, this powder is Indian curry powder, which obviously has the chili powder, the turmeric, and rest of the spices on the picture out there. It's fine, it's all grinded together, so it's fine. We also have jeera and lot of the other things that these people use as their basis, like thyme is there. You have the coriander leaves which are dried. You also have mint leaves that are dry, but most of it is also available fresh. It's a bit costly if you buy fresh, but it is available if you need them to be. Yes, and you also get turmeric powder in here if you wanted to know that. Today I can't seem to find where it is. I think this is turmeric powder, but I'm not sure. Yeah, it is turmeric powder. So most of these masalas are pretty cheap. For the turmeric powder is 19 rubles, the curry powder is 15. The cumin packet which I showed you, the whole cumin is 10, coriander powder is 7, but those are in really small quantities. So you need a lot of them to cook. For example, I go through like 5 to 6 packets of curry powder within 2 weeks to cook. So it takes that much to add the flavor that we need, but that's all we get. So we have come into the ramen section of the aisle. Me, who has grown only accustomed to Maggi, initially found it really difficult to eat the ramen in here, and most of it is in meat flavor, except for some which is in chicken flavor, or some might be in vegetable flavor, but those are really rare. Most of it is either chicken, beef or pork flavored. So you essentially cook those in pork broth, which is the preparator a masala that you get. So someone who has grown accustomed to Indian Maggi, it is really difficult to initially get adjusted to this. So this is the gram section. I don't know what type of grams they are. I'm pretty bad at those. But you can just see through it and you can guess it for yourself. The dal section, I'm really bad at it. So in here you can get different types of rices too. One is the long rice, one is the short one, which these people use for making plovs. It is a kind of Uzbekistani that side kind of a dish, which is similar to our biryani, but it doesn't taste that good. It's okay. So there is also jasmine rice, there is also our basmati. It costs around, let me tell you, the least one costs 120 rubles for 500 grams. So we have come to the favorite section of mine in the grocery store, the coffee section. I am a coffee kind of guy, not a tea kind of guy, because I don't have it with sugar or any sweetener. So tea tastes better when it is sweetened. The coffee in here is the non-chicory version that we have in India, and the coffee is also comparatively cheap to India. The tea is okay. My friends have said the tea is okay. You also get tea leaves, tea dusts and tea dip bags, if that's of any concern. Also, this is the snack section. The snack section is really scarce in compared to India. They don't have a lot of biscuits. Also, most of the snack section is entirely sweet. You can't find any spicy snacks out in here. So that's a craving that you would have until you visit India the next time, or you bring in your snacks along with you. So that's a concern. The snack section is really scarce and you don't get a lot of good snacks out in here, and most of it is sweet. I think rest of the section is actually just the same as India, like the shampoo section, the soap section. Most of the things you get in India, you also get it in here, and most of the prices are the same. So one main difference that I see between here and India is the meat section which we have, and the bread section that we have in here. That is the bakery section that we have in here. So these two are the main differences, and also the masala section, which I already told you about. So I think I have got most of what I needed. Let's go to check out and let's get going to our dormitories. So till the next video, this is me signing off. Like, share and subscribe the video, and I'll see you in the next one.